Hi, hello students. How are you? Okay, fine. Let us start the class. Okay, at first you take one max note and pen. After you sit this class. Okay, go and take that notes. How you take? Okay, I start the class. Grade 8 max. That is a chapter. Chapter 1, this is rational numbers. Already we saw first class. In the previous class, what we discussed about number system, introduction of rational numbers, simplification of rational numbers, and assignment. Number system means whole number, rational number, integers, positive integer, negative integer, rational numbers, in everything, number system, everything. We learned the previous class. Next, introduction of rational numbers. I ask some questions to you. What is the form of rational number? P by Q. Then, what is the condition of P by Q? Q is not equal to 0. What is the difference between fraction and rational number? Fraction is numerator divided by denominator. Then, rational number is numerator divided by denominator. Then, denominator is always not equal to 0. This is called that rational numbers. So rational numbers are derived from where? Fractions. Okay. Next, simplification. Simplification sums also you learn in the previous class. Okay. At last, assignment. Assignment, I gave 3 sums on the day. Have you complete? I hope you are all complete the sums. This is assignment sums. So shall you check your answer? Here I show the answers for you. So 35 by 45 simplification, 35 by 45 first sum. So 35, 45. See this last digit 35. 45 last digit is 5. So 5, 5. Numerator also last digit is 5. Denominator also last digit is 5. So the common divisor is 5. So 35 divided by 5. 45 is also divided by 5. So 7 5s are 35, 9 5s are 45. So the answer is 7 by 9. See this B sum, 18 by 45. So 18 and 45 common divisor is 3. So 18 by 3, 18 divided by 3, 45 divided by 3. 18 divided by 3 answer is 6 by 15. 6, 45 divided by 3 answer is 15. 6 by 15. Also have the common divisor. That common divisor is 3. 16 divided by 3. 15 divided by 3. So 2, 3s are 6. 5, 3s are 15. Next sum. 32 by 60. 32 and 60 common divisor is 4. So 8, 4s are 32. 15, 4s are 60. Check your answers. Next. Now, today you learn about arithmetic operations on rational numbers. What are the arithmetic operations? Addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Okay. See here. First we see that first operations. That is addition. Addition of rational numbers. So addition rational number means which form? P by Q form. So now we want to do that addition of two rational numbers. So I take A by B one rational number, C by D another one rational number. So now we want to do the addition. So A by B plus C by D. So first we want to see the denominators B and D. So these two denominators are different. So different denominator means what we do in that fraction, same like here also you want to do. So cross multiply A into D plus B into C divided by B into D. So A into D means AD plus B into C means BC by BD. Next, one example I show to you. So 5 by 4 plus 1 by 4. Here you first see the denominators 4, 4. Same denominators have you know. So you want to add the numerators alone. So 5 plus 1 is 6 by 4. Commonly you take the denominator as 4. So 5 plus 1 is 6, 6 by 4. 6 by 4 having the common divisor. That common divisor is 2. So 6 divided by 2 is 3. 4 divided by 2 is 2. So 3 by 2. Addition is over. Next we move to subtraction. subtraction of rational numbers, same like a by b minus c by d. See the denominators, both the denominators are different, so we want to do the cross multiply, ad minus bc divided by bd. See that x, ad, a into d is ad, b into c is bc divided by b into d is bd. Next see that example, 5 by 7 minus 1 by 7. See the denominators, both the denominators are same denominators, so we take that same denominator 7. So numerator around we want to subtract, 5 minus 4. So 5 minus 4 is 5 minus 1 is 4, very good. So 4 by 7. 4 by 7 doesn't have the common divisor, so that's all, subtraction also over. Next move to multiplication of rational numbers, a by b into c by d. So here we want to do in that multiple of numerator into numerator, denominator into denominator. So numerator is a, here numerator, second number numerator is c, so a into c divided by b into d. So a into c is ac, b into d is bd. See that example sum, 1 by 3 into 3 by 5, 1 by 3 into 3 by 5. So how we want to multiply 1 into 3, 3 into 5, 1 into 3, 3 into 5, 1 3 is 3, 3 5 is 15, 1 3 is 3, 5 3 is 15. So answer is 1 by 5. Next we move to division of rational numbers, a by b divided by c by d. In the fraction, how to do the division? Division sign is changes to multiplication. Next take the reciprocal of second number. So here also same like, so a by b division is changes to multiplication, c by d reciprocal is d by c. See that example, 1 by 4 divided by 1 by 6. So division becomes changes to multiplication, then 1 by 6 reciprocal is 6 by 1. So 1 by 4 into 6 by 1. So same like 1 by 6 and 1 into 6, 6, 4 into 1, 4. So 6 by 4 have the common divisor is 2. So 3 2s are 6, 2 2s are 4. So 3 by 2. So our 4 arithmetic operations also over. Next we move to properties of rational numbers. So properties means that it has 4 properties. Already you learn about this 4 properties in your previous 7th standard integer, integer chapter. Whole numbers and everything, you want to use this properties. So what are the 4 properties? Closure, commutative, associative and distributive. Here we use this 4 properties and rational numbers. So rational number, I take 3 rational number, a, b and c, 3 rational numbers. Closure property means a plus b equal to c, sum of any 2 rational numbers, we get this answer is also a rational number. So this is called the closure property. Second one is commutative property. What is commutative property? A plus b equal to b plus a. So this is nothing but, for example, 1 plus 2 equal to 2 plus 1. So 1 and 2 number is changes. First number is going to LHS side, first number is going to RHS side, second number. RHS side first number is going to the second number, this like alone. A plus B. B alone changes. B here having second number. In the right hand side, B having the first number, first place. Okay, so a plus b equal to b plus a. This is commutative property. Then associative property. A plus b plus c equal to a plus b plus c. This is called that associative property. Distributive property over multiplications alone I gave here. So that alone having distributive property only multiplications alone. So a into b plus c equal to ab plus ac. Ab plus ac. See here. Don't fear about these examples. This is not the sum. This is explained alone. Okay. You want to memorize the closure property means a plus b equal to c. That alone you want to understand. Okay. So closure means a plus b equal to c. That's all. This is for clarify you. That's all. Okay. Don't fear these examples. Don't see and fear that examples. Next, commutative property. A plus B equal to B plus A. How it is possible? You are asking, you know. So alone, I see that examples. Okay. If you have any doubt, means clarify those examples. A plus B equal to B plus A. See this next one. This is multiplication and division of associative commutative property. Third one is associative property. A plus B, B plus C into A plus B plus C. This is multiplication and division of associative property. Distributive property. A into B plus C equal to AB plus BC. AB plus BC. See this first one, closure property. What is closure property? A plus B equal to C. A plus B equal to C. So in this closure property, addition also possible, subtraction also possible, multiplication also possible, but division alone not possible. Why ma'am? This is nothing but in the division we want to divided by 0. 0 is also one of the rational number. So any number is divided by 0, we get that answer is not defined, that is infinity alone. Okay, so division alone, closure property is not possible. Remaining three operations, that is possible to the closure property. Commutative property also, addition is possible, multiplication is possible, but subtraction is not possible. Then division also not possible. Here division is also not possible to the commutative property. Associative property also same, like addition and multiplication possible, subtraction and division is not possible to that associative property. Distributive property, both on us possible, addition and subtraction is also possible to the distributive property. Next we see that example sum. Using appropriate properties, find the answers. So minus 4 by 5 into 3 by 7 plus 4 by 5 into 3 by 7. See this number, which is the same number here having 3 by 7 and 3 by 7. So commonly I take the 3 by 7 in outside. In within the bracket, minus 4 by 5 plus 4 by 5. Okay, so which property here using? A into B plus C. So A into B plus C, this is called distributive property. So by using distributive property here, 3 by 7 is commonly we take outside, minus 4 by 5 plus 4 by 5. So denominators are same. So minus 4 plus 4 is 0. 0 by 5 is 0. So 3 by 7 into 0 is 0. Next up, this is exercise 1.1, first sum. Minus 2 by 3 into 3 by 5 plus 5 by 2 minus 3 by 5 into 1 by 6. Minus 2 by 3 into 3 by 5 minus 3 by 5. Which property here we want to use? A into B minus B into C. So which property? A plus B equal to B plus A. So which one? This one is commutative property. So here we use commutative property. Okay, ma'am. So minus 3 by 2 minus 2 by 3 into 3 by 5 minus 3 by 5. I change the places alone. Minus 3 by 5 into 1 by 6. At last we want to write that plus 5 by 2. Okay. So minus 2 here, my 3 by 5 here also 3 by 5. So I take the 3 by 5 in outsides. So minus 3 by 5 into 2 by 3. Here I take minus, you know. So in that, within the bracket, I write positive number 2 by 3. So 2 by 3 plus 1 by 6 plus 5 by 2. So minus 3 by 2. 3 and 6 is which property is using? A into B plus C. So A into B plus C is called distributive property. So here by using distributive property. So here denominators are different. So we take that LCM, 3 and 6 is 6. So 2 2s are 4. 4 plus 1 is 5. 5 by 6 plus 5 by 2. So here 5 and 5 is same number. So cross multiple. 1 3 is 3. 2 3s are 6. So minus 1 by 2 plus 5 by 2. So add this number. 5 minus 1 is 4 by 2. 4 by 2 is 2. So the answer is minus 2 by 3 into 3 by 5 plus 5 by 2 minus 3 by 5 into 1 by 6 is 2. Note it on your max note. Okay, this is 1.1 first sum. Note it on your max note. First, you want to write the properties. 3-4 properties you want to write: closure, commutative, associative, and distributive property. Then you write exercise 1.1. Write this one. Okay. Next, I gave one worksheet for you. See this one. First parameter is fill in the blanks. Yes, sir. The rational number 10, 11 in the form of P by Q is dash. So P by Q format, you want to write in that, using these two numbers, you write the form of rational number. 10 and 11 using, write that rational number P by Q form. So 1 by 5 into 2 by 7 plus 3 by 8 equal to 1 by 5 into 2 by 7. Which property for this one? 1 by 5 into 2 by 7 plus 3 by 8. A into B plus C. So which property? A into B plus C. A into B plus C is distributive property. Very good. 1/5 into 2/7 plus dash. What is our next value? See the C1. 2/3 into 4/5 equal to 4/5 into 2/3. Represent the dash property. Which what property here using? D also what property using in this expression? So solve the sum using appropriate properties to find this value. Do this work, complete that worksheet in your max note. Thank you.